Johnny C, how are you, my friend? I'm at one of our favorite places over here, Nordy Rack, and just wanted to wish you a happy birthday, man. This is a place that you and I definitely have spent some time at, and had a lot of fun at, and you were always and forever my shopping guy, man. And you're a dear friend. You're a brother to me, and I just wanted to wish you a very happy birthday. So lots of love over here, man. And I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Hi, John. It's Oliver. I just wanted to say happy birthday, and I'm excited to see you again soon. Have a really great birthday. Bye.
Happy birthday, John. I'm wearing my favorite shirt that you got me. I hope you have a great birthday, and I hope to see you soon.
Happy birthday, John. Have a good birthday.
Say happy birthday, Wolf. Happy birthday, John. Hi, John. Happy birthday. Wearing your John jacket. I hope you feel very special and loved today.
Hey, John. Happy birthday. Miss ya. Hope to see you soon. Rocking some John gear here from Christmas a few years ago. Can always count on you to stock my closet during the holiday season. As Jill can admit, I'm not much of a shopper, so happy 58th. Hope to see you soon. Have a great one.
We love you.
Love you too, John.
Happy birthday to one of my longest friendships in LA. Great guy, legendary storyteller, but above everything else he's done, maybe most impressive was getting a Jewish kid from Chicago to root for the hated Notre Dame. Yep, happy birthday, John. Go Irish.
Hey, John. It's Darren Ouellette from around the block. Hey, I still remember those days playing sports in the street. Whatever sport, whatever season the sport was, we were out there playing it day and night until the streetlights went out. Oh, gosh. Those were good times, man. Those were good times. Getting pushed down on the street, bloody knees on the asphalt, playing football, getting stuffed by you in basketball. Oh my gosh. Remember that? In your face. Anyhow, buddy, hope you're doing well and you have a great birthday. Take care.
Hi, John. Just wanted to send you this message to wish you a very happy birthday. We love you. You're so special to us. And you do so many kind things for so many people, and you have so many people that love and adore you. So we just want to wish you a happy birthday. Hope you have a great day. You get to eat some chocolate cake, and you continue celebrating you because you're so special. We love you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, John. Miss seeing you. Hope to see you soon. Have a great celebration.
Hi, John. Hope you have a good birthday. And by the way, I love this jersey. Bye. Love you.
Happy birthday, John.
Happy birthday.
Love you.
Love
you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear John. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, John. I love you. Have a great birthday.
But this is, by the way, this is, so we're doing this show. This one is on the birthday of a very dear friend of ours, one of the coolest cats that I've ever known, John Carlin. Can I tell you a quick John Carlin story as we go to break?
Sure, if I can do one on the back end.
Which is amazing, by the way, that I'm told John is, Kevin tells me John's 58. If ever someone is forever cherubic, it's John, not you and me. You could read every scotch all along the neck. So John has us to Jimmy Kimmel, has me and the students, about 20 students. We come in like five cars, and my car was at the front, and we're leaving, and it was great. And we go back, and that Monday or Tuesday back at school is a Friday night. One of my students comes in, he goes, "Oh, Pete, it was so good." He goes, "John intercepted us as we were leaving." He goes, "Any of the Chapman kids still here?" And he goes, "You guys wait, you go back." And he goes, and we went back, and it was about 10 of us. And he went down the line with every one of us, asked us what we wanted to do in our TV careers. Then if there was a relevant person, he brought out like the head writer, he brought out the head guy from the union, from NABIT, whatever it was.
Yeah. People really
all met us. He goes, it was unbelievable. He goes, we were there for 2 hours. And I go, well, that's unbelievable. And I think, you know, like weeks later or something, I was talking to John and I said, why didn't you tell me this that you did? He goes, nah. And he goes, I'm sorry I missed you. He goes, I didn't know if I could, you know, do it, but turns out I could. And it's the old line, Jim. It's character and brilliance and is what you have when nobody's watching.
The last time we were together, I said that was one of my dad's favorite quotes and he didn't make it up. But reputation is what you do when everyone's watching and character is how you behave when no one's looking. That was always my dad's thing, right? Because it's the right thing. That's what he always used to say. I was looking for something the other day and I thought John might enjoy it. Let's see if I can find it. No, I don't know. Sorry, there's so much stuff on my desk. Sorry. I'll find it here eventually. No, that's not it either. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's here somewhere. I can't remember exactly where it is. Clean it out.
You have any luck finding that thing you're looking for?
Sorry, I apologize. It's in a box marked clutter. See if I can move them out of the way there.
I should have mentioned, Jim, the way I have the view set up on Zoom is you're kind of in a thumbnail. So that's just going to look like, kind of like rusted screws. But go ahead.
That's what they are at my house. All right. So I used to keep a diary, a journal, because I'm a man. I used to keep a journal back in the day because, as you know, because you were there, about midway through my indentured servitude at OCN, what I call the crustaceous period of the Milky Epoch, I was seriously thinking about quitting. I was getting frustrated. I was like the fourth man in a three-man department.
You count Feldman as a man?
Nipping at my heels, the pride of Pleasant Valley High School. And so I'm like, well, this is going nowhere. I'm like, I'm making like 40K. I got to get out of here. And I knew I was being underappreciated because I realized what an incredible role model I was for the youth of Orange County. So I started keeping a journal, right? I was talking to somebody and somebody told me, oh, you write it all down. You feel better. It's cathartic. So a couple of entries. And this is the one where Carlin comes to mind. So August 1994, although I'm wildly talented, my potential is like a streaking comet. I don't know how much longer I can allow my tiger talents to be caged. I may have to leave OCN to pursue other opportunities. For weeks now, I've been getting lots of interest from the talent scouts and Herbalife. I'm also getting some serious sniffs from Amway and Mary Kay. Obviously, I'm in demand. October 1995. I feel suffocated under Milky's iron fist, Feldy's incessant whining, and Overall's binge eating. I don't know how much longer I can keep myself from jumping the fence. I yearn to be free, to let the cliches flow like the waters of an eternal spring, to allow sound bites to run unfettered and not give the ladies equal time. It may be my time to hang up my tweed jacket and my skinny ties. December 1995, CIF playoffs began last night. I think modern day is overrated. They rely way too much on some hack named Grootegood. I predict he'll never amount to anything. Feldman is still humping Rawlinson's leg like Jeff Van Gundy. Went to TGI Fridays to celebrate afterwards. Three Bud Lights later, I'm ready to quit. I find myself in the parking lot at 2 a.m. with a doe-eyed, tipsy mini skirt of an intern who needs help picking classes for the fall quarter at Rancho Santiago. When up walks John Carlin, my intern, I give him several hints to leave, but JC not picking up on the vibe. He drones on as usual about how grateful he is for the chance to work with me. I tell him I'm taking my talents to the exciting field of online questionable weight loss powders, and I'm going to quit OCN. Carlin's eyes fill with tears. His voice cracks, and he tells me that he thinks that's a mistake. He tells me what an inspiration I've been to him and thousands of other lost souls, that my beacon of truth cuts through much of the milky and Feldy fog, the round mound of the rebound Overall. He says he knows how I feel and that it's obvious to all that I'm the David Lee Roth of this group. And I bring out the best that the four of us bring out the best in one another. He says, you're like that British Fab Four. And I said, you mean the Beatles? And Carlin says, no, I was talking about Coldplay.
I thought they were talking about it.
I said, didn't the New York Times called Coldplay the most insufferable band of the 90s and a bunch of overdramatic, self-indulgent bedwetters? And Carlin yells, exactly. So I went home. I thought about what Carlin said for a long time. And then I quit the next morning and went on to a stunningly successful career. I owe it all to Carlin's incredible motivational words in that parking lot at TGI Fridays.
Love you, love you. Jim and I are going to go visit you again at the Irvine Arms there. Some of those gals look like...
After we gazelles. Get rid of Carlin that day, let's stay a little bit longer and work the pool deck.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Anyway, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, John.
I dedicate this game to my Uncle John, and yeah.
Go, bro!
That was a nice shot!
Go, Drew, go!
Uncle John, I'm dedicating this game to you.
I averaged the whole thing. Get the whole thing.
All right, James!
Yay!
Oh.
Nice!
Yay, James! Good on you! Let's go, Big James!
Woo! Hey! Hey, Uncle John, I gave this game to you.
Okay. Good, Wyatt. All right, get it over to him. Give him a good pitch. Use your other hand. That hand, yeah. Good. Oh, right in his glove. Wyatt. How'd you get so good at baseball?
I tried to catch you.
Yeah, it's good.
Hey, John. Phil Roach here. Oh, my goodness, my friend. It's been a long, long time. I had a lot more hair back the last time I probably saw you, but I hear you got a birthday coming up. Happy birthday to you, my friend. I hope you have a wonderful day on your special day, and... Yeah, I'd love to get together sometime and just say hello, and just wishing you all the best, buddy. And it's been too many years. My brother Ed reminded me I should probably mention the fight you and I got into one day in about, I don't know, 1978 or 9. We were both, I think, tired and sick of pushing each other around playing flag football in the street. And all I remember was two of us like throwing hands at each other, but we were so tired we couldn't really punch. It was awesome. Anyway, buddy, oh, man, it's been too many years. You take good care, my friend, all right? Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, John, for me, Chelsea, and Cannoli.
Happy birthday, John. We love you.
Hi, I'm Freddie Roach.
I'm Vince Zimmer.
He wishes. John, we wanted to wish you...
Happy birthday.
That's for you, John Carlin. Don't go selling this.
Hey, John, Chad here. I just wanted to wish you a happy birthday. It's been a long time. Haven't seen you in a while. But a funny story. Yesterday, actually, my son was doing some homework, and I heard a pencil sharpener. And I'm like, what the heck? I haven't heard a pencil sharpener in a long time. So I went over to check it out, and he was sharpening his pencil with my old pencil sharpener. Let me show you this real quick. Check it out. Here it is. Rip it up. So I knew it was mine. It was pretty funny. Anyways, I thought you'd get a kick out of that. It's pretty funny. Happy birthday, John. I love you. I miss you. I hope to see you really soon.
Happy birthday, John Carlin. Hope you're having an awesome birthday. It's your marsh pit friend, Jim Evans, wishing you a happy birthday from back east Emmitsburg, Maryland. All right.
That's John when he was about 8 months old.
I got a special guest here that can't wait, needs to talk to John.
Oh, boy.
There he is, John, wishing you a happy birthday.
What do you happy say, Zozo? Can you say meow?
To John. Meow. Yeah, that was
he
good.
He said meow.
He did good.
He gets a treat.
He gets a treat.
Happy okay. birthday, John.
That's so
hard. We love you very much.
You're showing all my wrinkles.
There's nothing we can do about that.
What happened?
I don't know. Age happens.
I like that picture where John was born. I was throwing young. I was 23.
And Zozo was better.
24. How old was I?
I was 20 and you were 23.
No.
When John was born. Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah, 23. Now I'm almost 83.
No, you're not. You're 81.
But almost 83. John, that is the cutest picture. Let's show that again here. Yeah, that is a cute picture.
It is.
Okay. Now,
what happy happened? Birthday, John.
Happy birthday, John.
We love you very much.
Bozo says hi.
And you're going to get your usual 31 flavors mint chocolate chip ice cream with chocolate cake. That's something to look forward
wait a second.
To.
There's a group of people that want to say hi to John. No, don't say that. Eat your heart out, Brett.
The University of Notre Dame proudly presents its marching band, the Band of the Fighting Irish.
Several hours later,
John, it's your boys down here at the walk-ons. We just wanted to say a very special happy 58th birthday to you, man. You know we love you. You have had such a big hand in all of our careers and, of course, this show, so it'd be nothing without you. We love you, man. We hope you're doing well, and I'll toss it over to Andrew.
Hey, John, happy birthday. You know, can't thank you enough for everything you've done for me, and I'm sure Ryan and Seamus will say the same thing, as is everybody in your life. You've left an indelible mark on everyone you come across, and we can't thank you enough for your friendship. Happy birthday. Unashamed.
Nice. Hey, John, happy birthday, man. They kind of said everything that I wanted to say, but man, it's just been a joy to work with you on these projects and stuff and kind of get to know you even better than before. And I still plan to come see you next week, by the way. I'm looking forward to that. And happy birthday, man. We love you.
We love you, buddy. None of this would be possible without you. We really appreciate you. You're the best of the best. You're one of a kind. Happy birthday, John.
Happy birthday, Carlito. I'm sure there's someone out there that doesn't like you, but I've yet to meet them. Everyone loves you. You've always been there for me, especially in my time of need when I'm in my long meetings with Nick, and you're there to call, interrupt. Always fun to talk to you. Look forward to continuing to work with you. Just want to wish you a happy birthday. Have a great day.
Hey, John. Happy birthday. Hope you're having a great day.
Hi, Uncle John. Happy birthday. I miss you so much. I'm in Dublin right now, leaving for Amsterdam for the weekend. And I'm wearing the Patagonia jacket that you got me. I wear it all the time, every day. But I miss you so much and I love you. And I hope you have a great birthday. I can't wait to see you at Christmas. Bye.
Happy
birthday.
How much do we love him? We love him this much.
We love you.
Happy birthday,
Uncle John. Mwah. Miss you.
John Carlin, I love you, brother. You know that. Happy birthday. Thank you for all you've ever done for me. You are truly one of my best friends. I love you, brother. Happy birthday.
Mr. Carlin, someone told me it's your birthday. Oh my, happy birthday, dude.
Mr. Carlin, happy birthday, dude. I love you, man. I just want to let you know that I love you.
Happy birthday, John.
Love you. Oh, shit.
Oh. Hey!
Hi, John. Happy birthday. We're thinking of you today and hope to see you real soon. We love you and wish you a happy birthday.
Hi, John. We'll be thinking about you on your birthday, as we always do. Have a real happy birthday, and we'll hope to see you soon. Happy birthday.
Okay, happy birthday, bye-bye. John.
Hey, John. Happy birthday from your office neighbor and fellow Scorpion. I was thinking you and I share the honor of being the two people in the office who get bugged for tickets more than anyone else. So we got that in common. Happy birthday, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
John Carlin. Let's take the way, way back machine to 1982 and discover the brilliance of a band lip-syncing to the Romantics' What I Like About You at the El Toro Talent Show. Not only did you wear dark glasses and dance like a bunny, but you were the hit of the social scene, causing your brothers pure mortification. I can only say that me, myself, was in awe of you, and I think you are the greatest person of all time. Please keep on singing that song. Happy birthday, and many more. And I love you, my friend, Ed Roach.